Chloe Zhao's Eternal is a small but necessary step forward for the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Adapted from the Jack Kirby comics of the same name, Eternals follows the eponymous group of superheroes who've been created by the omnipotent Celestials to guide and shape evolution across the universe. Centuries after the group went their separate ways, the fractured family find themselves drawn back together by conspiracy and tragedy to help save the world one more time. Eternals has ambition and scale. At its core, this is a Marvel Studios film about confronting God. It's a big idea, one that traces its roots back to Jack Kirby's work with Stan Lee on Fantastic Four. Completely unironically, Eternals is at its best when it leans into this premise, allowing its beautiful cast moments of introspection, staring out over pretty vistas shot in impressive IMAX. There are moments when Eternals looks simply gorgeous. While there's something disconcerting in the extent to which Marvel Studios have been leaning on the fact that Eternals was directed by an actual filmmaker instead of a corporate algorithm, there are moments when it really does feel like Eternals was directed by an actual filmmaker. Indeed, it's hard not to compare the film to something like Zack Snyder's Justice League, the work of an auteur. One of the lines of criticism on Eternals will inevitably be that the film itself isn't sufficiently colorful, particularly when compared to the Jack Kirby comics that inspired it. However, it's also clear that Eternals looks exactly like Chloe Zhao wants it to look. That really shouldn't be a high bar to clear, but after watching recent films from the studio, it merits acknowledgement. That said, the film's at its weakest when it punctures these moments of contemplation with quips and references to other Marvel films. It seems incredibly insecure in the risks that it's taking, and so peppers dialogue with references to Thanos and the Avengers.
So now that Captain Rogers and Iron Man are both gone, who do you think's gonna lead the Avengers?
For a film ostensibly about humanity, the film often brushes aside any actual humanity in favor of blunt exposition. When a supporting human character discovers that he's been dating an immortal and magical being, his first questions aren't rooted in any emotional reality about how that affects their relationship, but instead in wondering what she was up to during Infinity War. When explaining why humanity deserves special treatment in all the cosmos, another character references the plot of Endgame.
But the people of this planet brought everyone back with a snap of a finger.
Eternals also has the Captain Marvel problem of essentially starting an hour too early, burdening its first act with unnecessary and overly detailed exposition that any savvy audience member will realize is window dressing for the actual story that the film wants to tell. As a result, Eternals spins its wheels for an hour before actually starting to tell the story that it wants to tell. The film's momentum is also staggered by a series of somewhat indulgent and overextended flashbacks, some of which verge on extremely poor taste. Some of the film's baggage comes from the source material, like the ancient astronaut's premise, and a completely unnecessary and thematically muddled subplot focusing on the monstrous deviants. Still, there is a lot to like here. To its credit, Eternals features the strongest third act of a Marvel film since Black Panther, in large part because Zhao manages to juxtapose the obligatory computer-generated spectacle with both genuine scale and tangible emotional stakes. The film takes its time getting there, but it sticks the landing when it needs to. Eternals is flawed, messy, and clumsy, but it is actually pushing itself. While the results aren't out of this world, they do rise above many of the film's contemporaries. Eternals is releasing in theaters from Friday, 5th November.